What's going on, guys? It's Harrison and Evan from the Wildlife Brothers. And last night, we were taking a little walk around our neighborhood, and as we were hanging out under a bit of artificial light, we actually came across one of our target insect species to feature for you guys this summer. We've wanted to showcase more local invertebrates here on the channel, and what better way to start out than by taking a look at one of the most incredible beetle species in our area, the reddish-brown stag beetle. These are the reddish-brown stag beetle, an incredibly iconic beetle species from here in Pennsylvania, and in fact, if you take a look at their bodies there, it is not hard to see where they get that name from. They have that rich red color that runs basically along their entire body and makes them very recognizable. Now, this is a species that can be found throughout most of the eastern United States, as well as in parts of Canada, although this is not a species we see terribly often. They're found in deciduous woodland habitats like we're in now, but actually, these two we found in an urban area by a source of artificial light. But the reason we don't see them very often is because in this stage, their adult stage, they only live for around 1 to 3 months during the breeding season. They spend about 2 years in their larval stage, then they'll pupate until they reach their adult stage. And now, once they're adults, they'll reach anywhere from 20 to 36 millimeters in length. The males will get a bit bigger than the females, and this is about as large as they will get. So these are two choice individuals. Now, because they're only in this adult stage for such a short window of time, this is a very rare and exciting opportunity for us to film. Reddish-brown stag beetles are primarily active between the months of May and August, and when these guys emerge in late spring, they'll start to feed a little bit, so they have the energy that they require for the breeding process. Now for the adults, they're going to be feeding on tree sap and other plant sugars, and as the larvae are developing, they're going to be feeding on decaying wood, which they make their nests out of as well. Now, being so large, these guys really don't have that many predators out here. Mostly birds are going to be the only animals that try and take a little stag beetle down. Now, one thing we wanted to highlight for you guys is the fact that the males and females of this species look very different. That's a characteristic that we call sexual dimorphism, when the males and the females do have different anatomical structures. So if you notice, the male has very large mandibles as compared to the female. You'll notice the male right here is in my right hand, and the female is right here in my left hand. Now the reason the males have evolved such massive mandibles is to help them out in the breeding process. So what they will do is males will come together and spar for the right to mate. The males will grab each other with those mandibles, throw each other around, and have a really big fight. And the victor, when they emerge, has the right to breed with all the females, and the loser has to leave and try and find a new patch of territory. The females, as you can see, have very small mandibles, which they only use for eating. And they do look a little bit intimidating. You can see just how large the mandibles are on the male, but in reality, these guys are actually quite docile towards humans and only use those mandibles for fighting amongst themselves. All right, so we're gonna let these little stag beetles back out into the environment where hopefully they can do some breeding and get the next generation going. Bye, guys. Getting to feature more insects on the channel is always very exciting for us, especially for a species like this that we've been catching since we were very young. And one of the things that's really cool about stag beetles is, as we've mentioned before, they're really only active for a small part of the year, so this was really a species we were hoping to capitalize on while they're still out. Definitely. So if you guys enjoyed this episode, leave a like on it and comment down below what you thought of these amazing little stag beetles. And make sure to subscribe to the Wildlife Brothers now, because we have so much content coming out for you guys soon that you will not want to miss. So we will see you guys in the next episode.